Hi guys, good morning. Today we're gonna do the mermaid. I'm squatting, getting my squats in. So today we're gonna do part one on the mermaid board. And I'll just show you the basics and you can color her any color you want. But I think you guys saw the first one that I did. You can see it. Once you get the basics of these little gals down, then you can make them your own. But the main thing is about proportion. So the body, the tail is going to be much bigger than the body, and you got to leave room for the head. So you just kind of eyeball it. I think we'll go there and there. And I'm just going to outline it with some black first. Give her, we'll come down a little bit because we might put a crown on her yet. Just give her an oval type shaped face. And there, her shoulders. Come out. Just get that shape on there. And then, let's see, let's go about here maybe. Go right about there. For the hips, where that tail is going to be. So then come up into her armpits. And just do an hourglass. Just like that. And then her arms, bring them down and bring it, cut in the elbow. And bring them in. Then she can be holding something and we'll get that. Paint on the other arm. And that way, I mean, you don't have to worry about painting any hands. Meets there. Are you getting the general outline here? You see it? I don't know if it's a bad angle. I can't get the phone down any further. Seeing that okay? Hope so. This? Does that help? Until I do that tail. Okay. So now the trick on the tail, and don't worry about outlining in black because you kind of want that. Because when you're painting it, when you're filling it in with the color, you're going to leave that black outline. So don't worry if you're getting thick or whatever. You want a little bit of that black to show. It's, oh, I don't know, skateboardish, pop artish, you know? Come back and get her boobies in a minute. I always like to put that little V in there. Let's give her that neck. Alright, so now on the tail, here's the thing. One side is going to be an S. Okay? The other side is going to be a C. Okay? So here's the S. And there's the C. Just bring that C all the way down. bring this out a little bit more, give her a little bit more hip. You can change that because you're going to paint over it anyway. So then you go along the board. If you run out of board, you can do it on anything. You can do this on a canvas. You can do this. Now, you can do one of different, two different tails. Let's see if I have, let's just use the back of this. So one of two different tails you can do. So your mermaid tail comes down like this on one, so you can do like that. So you can do one of those type of tails where it's two little fans or two little fins, or you can do this kind, like the fish tail. Can you kind of get that? Do you see the fish tail there and the two little fins there? So it's up to you which one you want to do. I did the fish tail one on the last one I did, so I think I'm going to do the two fins on this one. So just come up for one. Come up for the other one and around. Make it meet. Just like that. So then you have her basic outline. We have to put her. We'll be painting over it, but we'll be putting her shells on here. And all the shells are, well, you want her shape of her boobs on there first. So we're going to give her some, this is going to be, you can make them old, you can make them young. So I'm just trying to get the shape that I want. And then we'll put the shells over top of that. You'll see that later. And then her hair, depends on how you want her hair. If you want it flowing, if you want it to one side. You can always change that. I think we'll start with that. So we're going to come back to this black. So I'm going to cover that up. And now we'll just get some flesh color on her and the color of her tail going. I think I want to go pinks and reds, or pinks and oranges. Is that what I want to say? This does. And don't worry if that's going to smear you. You can fix it. But let's put that there. Let's get her skin tone. Now you can make her really tan, or make her any kind of skin tone you want. I use, this is a basic light beige acrylic. A little bit of that. And then we get a little bit of brown. Not much. I think I want a little bit of burnt sienna. Let's see what it does. Whatever brush you're comfortable with using, it's totally up to you. Is that drying? think I'm going to use something, I'm going to use a wide flat brush just to get going. And I'm just mixing the colors. I don't want her that dark, by golly. She'd look like she's fried. This is looking like it's a nice skin tone. Yeah, I like this. Because then we can always come back in and give her some shadows, you know. But get everything colored in, and then you can come back. Get that black out of there. I need a paper towel. Black in there. I didn't want that. Start giving her some shape. About this, because I'm going to put her little shell suit on her. Just want to get that flesh tone on her. For the first layer, anyway. Go up and get her face done. We're going to try and let that dry. We'll come back and get some more, a second layer of a flesh tone in and fill that in a little bit more. So then the next color I think we'll work on is her fins. Give her some neon pink, because this is going to be the same color as her shells, her suit up top. So let's see what this does. Like I said, this part you can just play around and put on whatever color you want. So if you just seriously just want to start mixing, just getting it on there. I think typically if you're going to do any kind of something about mixing your colors, start down at the bottom with your darkest color and then come up, start working up with your lighter shade. Like I said, this, I mean, you get the first layer on and then and I'm using a mixture of chalk paint and acrylics. So now I'm going to start mixing in. I don't want that blob on there. Now I'm going to start mixing in the lighter. As I come up, I'll get on this side. And then I want to bring in some pink. And you can switch to a wider brush if you want, it's okay. There'll be another layer on this too as well, so all this streakiness will go away. I'm just mixing the neon orange and the neon pink together for this top color. Wider brush probably would go faster, so I'll probably grab one here and maybe try and help smooth some of this out. I mean, it's okay. I'm not gonna freak out about it, but let's see what I can do with this. And actually, if you do this, probably an easier way to do it is gonna wet down your brush. You can spritz it a little bit with water. And make it go a little bit smoother. Alright, I think we can come back up here and play again. So we can cover this up and we'll come back to those colors. Back to your flesh tones. And I need more of that lighter color. not going to match the first one exactly like you did. So don't worry about that. Because you're going to want to give her some kind of highlights and stuff like that. So. We'll use white for that kind of stuff, but just filling in, blending. If there's a variation of different colors in there, just keep going over it. Not worried here because we're still going to cover that up. So, so now we'll get the color in the body. You guys can make your mermaids any way you want. If you want them to be a granny, you can make hot dog saggy boots. You can put wrinkles in her face, on her chest, and give her gray hair. If you want to make her a fulfilled mermaid, you can make her belly rounder. More round, and put little like chunky cheeks up there. You can make them whatever you want to do, but I'm just showing you the basics here so you can make your mermaid however you want. You can even make mermen or merboys, however you want to do it. It's totally up to you. Okay, so I'm going to take some of this really light color and give her, you know, where the sun might be highlighting on one side or something. Just blend it in. blend that in a little bit as you go. So on this side. Some on the top of the arms, you know how the sun always touches the tops, sun kisses the tops of your arms, maybe a little there. Okay, remember it's kind of pop artish, so the bottom isn't quite dry yet, so let's wait for this to dry. Let's go ahead and work on her hair. What kind of hair do we want to give her? I gave the last one blonde, so maybe we'll stick with this, but we're going to go a reddish brown. We'll just do that. That works. We can give her some, like, the sun streaked. Just use your imagination, however you want to make her hair. You make her your own kind of character. But these are just the basics for you. Alright, so I think we're done with the skin tones. I'm going to get bigger brush. We may have to put black back up there around her waist to kind of sometimes that acrylic doesn't dry. It definitely doesn't dry as fast as the chalk paint, so. put the pink kind of on one side just to highlight it. Clean that up. All right, let's do her, I think we can do her shells. So let's get them outlined. And I think they're on this one. And you know
what seashells look like.
We'll go get the color on there. And that's not performing for me. Just going to use another flat brush, I think. This one should probably work. I'm just going to go with the lighter color. I'm not going to go with that dark orange. First coat, keep in mind, we'll come back because that black is going to have to dry to at least be tacky enough for us to paint on top of it.
Hope you're still here. Hopefully my battery will outlast
everything.
So I want to quickly show you, before my phone dies,
some more things that you can do to this. Actually, what I might do,
I might let that dry, guys. And I'll let that dry. I'm going to go get my charge cord. And they'll come in and get this phone plugged in, then we can finish this up. So I will be back with part two in just a second.